and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. So we celebrate the fact that the Lord is faithful to his promise. Came to get our dear mother, sister, aunt, friend, has come to give her peace and rest around his throne. We gather and we say farewell to what is most familiar to us. We realize that while this is her body, she is not here. And she is not dead as you suppose, but she is living in the fullness of life around the throne of God. That is the comfort that we have in the Lord, knowing that she is in his presence. And so we thank God for the life that we share, and we give God the glory.
I'll be somewhere there. If it wasn't so, I would have told you that. I'm on my way to get a room ready for you. And if I'm on my way to get your room ready, I'll come back and get you so you can come and live with me. And you already know where I am, and you know what I'm talking about. Beloved, we all realize that grief is a personal and intense journey that all of us will experience at some point in our life. Today, as daughters, sons, brothers, sisters, grand, great grand, and extended family and friends, we have gathered today to celebrate the life of a great lady. We will all miss Flora, who was lovingly called Grandma. Scripture tells us that death should have a sting, but we all will have emotional hornets in the days ahead, because we're all left behind to mourn. Don't be surprised when each of us have our emotional sting. We will be possibly feeling separation anxiety, loss of identity, and it definitely will be accompanied with lots of tears. What a great loss. Scripture also tells us we must rejoice at Grandma's reunion with our Heavenly Father. While we're grappling in our mind, why did she have to go so soon? There was so much more we had to tell her. And we wish she was here right now with us on earth. So today, as we lay her to rest, let our hearts not be troubled. We must entrust in faith to be our autopilot, to help us get through the immediate days after the burial. The wonderful thing is, Grandma's with Jesus. And if I know her, she's sitting right now drinking sweet tea with her boo. And that's all right. Realize that the flowers will wilt, the phone calls will stop. But we must face the reality of choice and not let her passing consume us. Right away, we must gather courage to represent her life and her living her legacy and carry it on through the rest of our lives. After all, we have to impart it to the new babies that are coming. Although it may be hard to marinate right now, our lives will change with her gone. Just know that Flora's faith gained her eternal sight and when she left us to go see the Heavenly Father. Today, let's make a conscious decision to give our grief to Jesus and ask for his directions in the days ahead. If we live right, we all will see her again. Just remember, we make plans and make great to-do lists, but God's plan and will always prevail. I love you, Grandma.
Let us bow our heads together for a word of prayer. Father God, we come to you. You are the author of our faith. And we lift to you our weary longing eyes. Come thanking you for this moment in our life. We can think and remember on Sister Flora. And Lord, today we come also realizing that the pain of this moment is real. And the challenge to be strong is great. But Lord, you said that your strength is made perfect in our weakness. So today I pray that you would help our weak moment. Help our tears and help our fears. Help us, Lord, at this time where we're struggling not only with social issues but with personal pain. Lord, we pray that you would just draw your children of this family in close to you. Help them to know that you are still God, that you are still on the throne, and that you are still with them. Lord, thank you for your word that says that when we go through deep waters, you will be with us. And through the river, it won't overtake us. And when we walk through the fire, we shall not be burned. This feels like a fire of life, Lord. A hard thing to happen. But Lord, I trust in your comfort. I trust in your care for this people, that you would so enfold them and encourage them to know that earth hath no sorrow, that heaven can't heal. Now bless this family. Strengthen them where they're weak. Build them where they're torn down. Prop them on every leaning side. We pray in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
This morning, as we are gathered here to celebrate, there's a word that I find that is so powerful in the Bible at a time like this, that really identifies what the Lord is saying at a time where we're struggling. In the 91st Psalm, verse 9 through 11, he says, because you have made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, your habitation, there shall no evil befall you, neither shall a plague come near your dwelling. But he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. What is being said here, I believe, is a statement that if Sister Flora could tell you anything in this hour, she would say, let the Lord be your refuge. The Lord was my refuge, I believe she would say. She would tell you, let him be your refuge. And if you let the Lord be your refuge, the Lord will give his angels an assignment toward your life. That as you continue to walk your life, that he'll have angels watching over you, so the dangers that you can't see won't come close to you, so that plagues that is touching everyone else won't touch you. The Lord will make an assignment of the angels to watch over you. Can you hear Sister Flora as she prayed before she closed her eyes? Lord, watch out for my family. Take care of my children. Hold on to my grands and my great-grands. Let them know that even though I'm not there, you're still with them. And so today, as we say farewell to Sister Flora, the good news is that the Lord is with you. Even in this, he is with you. In fact, you can know that even when you're walking through this valley of the shadow of death, he is establishing goodness and mercy to walk with you, to comfort you, to be there for you. And so today, take trust in the fact that you can depend on God. The Lord has promised that he will give you peace if you just keep your mind staying on him. God bless you, family. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. It's from
married the love of her life, Herbert Verdell Gregg. She joined the Air Force and they became military families, traveling to many different places, eventually settling in Willisboro, New Jersey. From this union, five children were born, Billy Antoinette, Wanda Renee, Victory Stanley, Rita Inez, and Wayne Austin. We joined the church of the good shepherd, which we made a good and faithful member throughout the year. Flora had a large family of whom she was very proud, and she was always willing to welcome others to this extended family. Flora was affectionately memories are the key. We do it every day.
I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King, for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King, for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. I want to be where you are. Peace is where you are. Joy is where you are. I want to be where you are. And for the days that come to the family, I would say to you, you are my strength like no other, strength like no other, and it reaches to me. God, you are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other, and it reaches to me.
For as much as it is pleased Almighty God in His wise providence to take out of the world the soul of our deceased sister, mother, aunt, friend, Flora Gregg, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and the sea will give up their dead. The corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him will be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, from henceforth, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, even so saith the Spirit, for they rest from the labor. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Praise of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet communion and fellowship of His Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with you all forevermore. God bless you in the name of the Lord.
Amen. As we prepare to conclude our services, we do ask assistance of three ladies and serving floral bearers. Please go to receive the flowers and we have to take them near the hearse. The gentleman will be serving us all very soon. Some of your stuff might not be this fast.
Eric
Thank you.
Oh, here, I hold it.
I mean, that's why he hit me. That's why you want
to
hold this.
I thought he wanted to turn it off. This is a
shoe. Stacy, is this your umbrella? Take a step back, it's a big enough umbrella.
I got cold feet right up. What's going on, man? Hey.
Thank you.